right, we welcome you to the Father's house tonight. We're going to begin tonight by singing Under the Blood, Under the Precious Blood. Under the blood, under the precious blood. Being sanctified, totally set aside, under the precious blood. Under the blood, under the precious blood. Being sanctified, totally set aside, under the precious blood. Under the blood, under the precious blood. Being sanctified, totally set aside, under the precious blood. Under the blood, under the precious blood. Being sanctified, totally set aside, under the precious blood. Under the blood, under the precious blood. Being sanctified, totally set aside, under the precious blood. Under the blood, under the precious blood. Being sanctified, totally set aside, under the precious blood. Being sanctified, being sanctified, totally set aside, under the precious blood. Being sanctified, totally set aside, under the precious blood. Yes, Lord, we thank you for the beautiful day that you've given us, Lord, to come here today and worship you. Lord, we just thank you that you truly do cover us with your blood, Lord. Lord, we thank you that as we come into your presence tonight, that you are just preparing our hearts for all that you have for us. We thank you and praise you for that. In Jesus' name, amen. Let your spirit rise within me. Let your spirit rise within me. You set my feet a-dancing and my heart rejoicing and my mouth singing out your praise. Let your spirit rise within me. Let your spirit rise within me. You set my feet a-dancing and my heart rejoicing and my mouth singing out your praise. You alone are great God, to be praised. You alone are great God and worthy to be praised. Let your spirit rise within me. Let your spirit rise within me. You set my feet a-dancing and my heart rejoicing and my mouth singing out your praise. Let your spirit rise within me. Let your spirit rise within me. You set my feet a-dancing and my heart rejoicing and my mouth singing out your praise. You alone are great God and worthy to be praised. You alone are great God and worthy to be praised. You alone. You alone are great God and worthy to be praised. You alone are great God and worthy to be praised. Let your spirit rise within me. Let your spirit rise within me. You set my feet a-dancing and my heart rejoicing and my mouth singing out your praise. Let your spirit rise within me. Let your spirit rise within me. You set my feet a-dancing and my heart rejoicing and my mouth singing out your praise. You alone are great God and and worthy to be praised. You alone are great God and worthy to be praised. Let your spirit rise within me. Let your spirit rise within me. You set my feet a-dancing and my heart rejoicing and my mouth singing out your praise. Let your spirit rise within me. Let your spirit rise within me. You set my feet a-dancing and my heart rejoicing and my mouth singing out your praise. You alone are great God and worthy to be praised. You alone are great God and worthy to be praised. You alone are great God and worthy to be praised. You alone are great God and worthy to be to him, he will answer us. If we run to him, he will run to us. If we lift our hands, he will lift us up. Come and praise his name, all you saints of God. Sing for joy to God. Call to him, he will answer us. We run to him, he will run to us. We lift our hands, he will lift us up. Come now, praise his name, we saints of God. Sing, sing for joy to God our strength. Sing, sing for joy to God. Near to him, he is near with us. Give him your love, he's in love with us. He will heal our hearts, he will heal our land. We rend our hearts, he will heal our land. Sing, sing for joy to God our strength. Sing, sing for joy to God. Draw near to him, draw near to him, he is near with us. Give him your love, he's in love with us. He will heal our hearts, he will cleanse our hands. We rend our hearts, he will heal our lands. Sing, sing for joy to God our strength. Sing, sing for joy. Sing, sing for joy to God our strength. Sing, sing for joy to God our strength. Oh, sing, sing for joy to God our strength. Sing, sing for joy to God our strength, our strength. If we call to him, he will answer us. If we run to him, he will run to us. If we lift our hands, he will lift us up. Come now, praise his name, all you saints of God. And sing, sing for joy to God our strength. Sing. strength.
Oh, sing for joy. You got our strength. Sing for joy. You got our strength.
Our strength. Our strength. Our strength. Our strength.
And sing, sing for joy to God, God our strength. Yes, sing, sing for joy to God our strength.
Yes, our strength. Hallelujah.
Sing, sing for joy. God, our strength. Sing, sing for joy to God, our strength. Oh, sing, sing for joy to God, God, our strength. Yes, sing, sing for joy to God, our strength, oh, our strength. Yes, Lord, our strength. Yes, Lord, you are our strength. Praise you, Lord. Yes, we worship you, Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord, you are our strength. Lifting our hands to you, here we are, giving you thanks for all you do, as we praise and worship your holy name. You are here, dwelling within our prayers. Here we are, lifting our hands to you. Here we are, giving you thanks for all you do, and as we praise and worship your holy name, you are here, dwelling within our prayers. For every answered prayer, for always being there,
love that hears us when we call. For arms that lift us when we fall. You have always been right beside us, leading us along the way. And we made it through. Yes, we made it through because of you. Here we are, lifting our hands to you. Here we are, giving you thanks for all you do. Worship your holy name. You are here, dwelling within our prayers, for every answered prayer, for always being there. Love that hears us when we call. For arms that lift us when we fall. You have always been right beside us, leading us along the way. And we made it through. Yes, we made it through because of you. Here we are, lifting our hands to you. Here we are, giving you thanks for all you do. Worship your holy name. Lord, you are here, dwelling within our praise. Lord, here we are, Lord. Here we are, lifting our hands to you. Your holy name. You are here, dwelling within our prayers. Lord, here we are, lifting our hands to you. Here we are, giving you thanks for all you do. And as we praise and worship your holy name, you are here. Lord, as we praise and worship your holy name,
Lord, you are here, dwelling within our praise.
And as we praise,
and worship your holy name, Lord, you are here, dwelling within our praise.
Lord, you are here.
You are here.
The hearing be clear, that you hear and understand, that you realize all that I, your Father God, am doing for you, that you understand and know the power and the authority and the ability that I have given unto you, to let you know that you're an heir. You're a joint heir. You're of the Father's house. You are all that I have said that you are. You can do all that I said that you could do. Bind up those things that hinder you. Cast down those things that come against you. Let my word fill your mouth. Let my word come to pass. For truly you're living in a very dark hour. Darkness is covering the face of the earth. Many do not see. Many do not understand. Many have a veil over their face, and their eyes have not been unveiled that they can see into the supernatural, into the spirit realm, that they can walk in the fullness of everything that I have said. Be not fearful. Do not allow fear to enter in. Let my word be quick to come out of your mouth. Let my word go forth and come not back void, but let it do the things that I, your Father God, has set it forth to do. For there shall be many things this week, saith your Father God, many things that take place. The forest fires will grow larger. The drought will expand more. Earthquakes, powerful earthquakes, shall be seen quickly. The shaking, the things that develop in Greece, the things that shall take place throughout all the European common market. Know my word, stand on my word, for it is an hour, it is a time that my word must go forth. Bind up those things that are not of me. But let my word be spoken. For one shall put 1,000 to flight, 2 shall put 10,000. One armor of David, one of his mighty men, would put even more. You have heard of the two elections. You know what shall take place. You've heard of what Russia is doing and how she is supplying your enemy, Syria. You've heard of the things that are taking place. It is not new to you, but you're almost new to me, saith your Father. For you listen not, you do not pay attention to the things that I say. You're rebellious, stiff-necked, for you have not changed. Even though the hour is extremely late, even though I have spoken so clearly to you, and yet little, very little has been accomplished. I see that even in my church of my son, Jesus Christ. rebellion, stiff-necked, disobedient, not listening. My heart is very concerned, for your days are much longer on earth than their day. And the troubles that shall be during your day will be thousands upon thousands of times greater. Oh, that you'd wake up. Wake up before the dawn. Wake up. Wake up. Look. See. Listen. Hear. For the hour is extremely late.
So also does your adversary, the devil, know the lateness of the hour. He knows that soon my son will come and take the church out. And therefore he is fighting like he has never fought before, fighting to win over the hearts of those who are not living the life they're supposed to be. So I say unto you, my people, follow me, for I, your Father God, am your deliverer. I, your Father God, am the one who brings you the victory. I, your Father God, am the one that makes you the overcomer. So therefore I say unto you, run like you've never run for me before, and accomplish all the things that I have called you for this day and this hour. For truly my word says, even the very elect shall be deceived. Draw ever closer to me. Know my voice like never before. Study my word to show thyself approved, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed. For truly the end result for the one who does that is victory, saith the Lord.
Be glorified, be glorified, be glorified, be glorified, be glorified in the heavens.
glorified.
Be glorified. Be glorified. Be glorified. Be glorified. Be glorified in the heaven. Be glorified in the earth. Be glorified in this temple. Jesus, Jesus, be thou glorified. Jesus, Jesus, be thou glorified.
Yes, Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus, be thou glorified. Jesus, Jesus, be thou glorified.
Oh, Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus. Be thou glorified. Be thou glorified.
Jesus, Lord, just be glorified in our lives and everything we do, Lord God. Hallelujah. Amen. It is definitely a joy and an honor to come into the presence of the Lord and worship Him. Amen. Pastor Dennis.
Praise God. Privilege again to give to the Lord all that belongs to Him and a little bit extra. Praise God. Praise the Lord. It's our normal giving tonight. Thank you for your faithfulness to the Lord. Father, we thank you and praise you for the privilege of giving. Once again, we ask you to bless gift and giver. Meet each and every need, Lord. Move powerfully and mightily in behalf of each one. Amen. Amen. We shall come as one before the Lord. We shall come as one before the Lord. We shall come as one before the Lord. Hallelujah, glory to the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
glory to the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, glory to the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, glory to the Lord. Hallelujah, glory to the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. All right. Well, it's a normal week this week. We have softball tomorrow night, church on Wednesday night. Of course, church again next Sunday. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And we are getting ready for camp meeting 2012. And that's coming up in a couple of weeks. 2.5 weeks, I guess, or so. And, boy, it's coming up swiftly. Praise the Lord. So we're just reminding people, keep that in your hearts and minds, on your calendars, and we just love to have others come too as well. Praise God. It just seems like the Spirit of God is moving mightily, powerfully, even now in our services, and we're just looking forward to all that God has at camp meeting time. Amen. Praise God. Wow. Hallelujah. Along with, of course, activities for the children and so on. My, praise the Lord for all of that. Hallelujah. All right. Praise God. Anybody want to give a word of testimony tonight before we have the preaching of the word and so on? Well, do it. Quickly, praise the Lord. Amen. Praise God. She's praising the Lord for people bringing, coming across her pathway to witness to. Amen. Yes, Pastor. Right. Amen. All right. Prayer requests. Praise God. Yes. Father, we just bring that one before you right now, Lord. We just ask you to continue to minister to her, meet her each and every need, Lord. We thank you and praise you for it. Amen. Hallelujah. All right. I don't think, I'm not forgetting anything, am I? We're going to have a song a little bit later. Praise God. I guess it's time for Dan to come up and deliver the word tonight. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Are you wired up, Dan, or you got to get wired up? Better get wired up. All right, who's going to help Dan get wired up here?
He's already wired up. Wired up.
Randy, how about if you help him, brother? He's back in the sound room. All right. Praise God. Well, those of us who are going to Africa probably will have prayer later on after the service. Just gather around to the front for prayer before we leave. So we just keep us in your prayers. Praise God. We desire to do whatever God has for us this week. And we're just
special.
Trusting we can come home with some good reports of what the Lord is doing and has done just in our little short stay there. So praise God. All right. Praise God. Are you ready?
I think so.
All right. Go ahead, Dan. Take it away and give us both barrels.
Well, this ties in with Randy's and Pastor Evans's messages they had last Sunday. Kind of. Not the same thing, but it kind of ties in. This is like it's a two-part thing. It's the gift of choice and choose Jesus.
Amen.
God gave us a gift of choice. Choices have been made since the beginning of time. Even God made choices. God chose to create the heavens and the earth. God chose to create man. God chose to create hell for his fallen angels and sinners. He chose to create man after his own image. And he chose to give man the gift of choice to make our own decisions. We're not God's puppets, you know. We pull all the strings and we do what he says every second. He gave us a gift of choice to do what we want from the moment we wake up till we go back to bed. It's up to us to make the right decisions. We may pray to God for guidance in our decision making, but ultimately, in the end, we create our own destiny. Every decision we make could either have positive or negative consequences, of course. I'll skip over that little section. It's getting a little later than I wanted it to be. But don't be skipping. Okay. I was just going to say we can choose to run red lights. That, of course, would be negative consequences. You know, you get speeding tickets or accidents or something like that. Or we choose the right thing to stay there and wait for the green light. You do that, you're not sinning, of course. You're not getting a chance of getting a ticket or laws being broken or anything like that. Moving on, I believe the first choice recorded in the Bible, correct me if I'm wrong, is... When she made a choice to eat of the forbidden fruit. In Genesis 2:16-17, and the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden thou mayest freely eat, but the tree of the knowledge of good and evil thou shalt not eat of it. For the day thou eatest thereof thou shalt surely die. But in Genesis 3:4-6, the serpent said to the woman, ye shall not surely die, for God knows that in the day you eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, and ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil. The woman saw that the tree was good for food, and was pleasant to the eyes, and a tree to be desired to make one wise. She took of the fruit thereof, and did eat, and also gave to her husband. Their eyes were open to knowledge of good and evil and their own nakedness. They knew no sin before. They lived in a sinless, perfect, beautiful place. But because of their bad choice, their decision to listen to and be deceived by the serpent, their decision to disobey God, God had to punish them. In Genesis 22:23, and the Lord God said, behold, the man has become as one of us, to know good and evil. And now, lest he put forth his hand, and take also of the tree of life, and eat and live forever, therefore the God sent him forth from the Garden of Eden. At this point in time, man has already made the choice to disobey God, man's first sin. So God ran Adam and Eve out of the garden, so they would not be able to eat of the tree of life anymore, possibly living forever, doing evil things. He had to put a stop to it, so he kicked them out. So God made good on his promise that if they eat of the tree of knowledge of good and evil, that they would surely die. They, of course, didn't die immediately, but their life expectancy was drastically shortened, and because they weren't allowed to eat of the tree of life anymore. So Eve's choice to disobey God came with some serious bad repercussions. We're all paying for it. Okay to tell a little joke here? You don't want to hear it? Okay, I'm going to say it anyways. One day, after being driven out of the garden, Adam and his son Abel were walking past the Garden of Eden. Abel says, "So, Dad, you and Mom used to live there, huh?" Adam says, "Yes, son, it was lovely." Abel asks, "Why did you leave?" Adam replied, "Your mother ate us out of house and home." I'm as nervous as the first time I preached. Sweating like a con under oath here. There are decisions, though, made throughout the Bible that have had positive outcomes because of our choice to worship God. One example is Noah deciding to be a God-fearing person. To walk in fellowship with our Lord, he and his wife and children and his children's wives and at least one pair of every living creature's lives were spared from the flood that wiped out every living thing on earth. Nobody else was spared because they were not worthy. God chose to spare his most trustworthy follower and believer. In Genesis 37 through Genesis 50, of course I'm not going to read all that, but Jacob's sons made a decision to sell their youngest brother into slavery, youngest brother Joseph. But because Joseph had a special relationship with God, he could interpret dreams, and he was chosen to be Pharaoh's right-hand man, ultimately to deliver many people, including his own family, from the 7 years of famine in Egypt. In Exodus 1:22 through the end of Exodus 14, Pharaoh said all the male children were to be killed. Moses' mother decided to spare his life and hide him, and Pharaoh's daughter found him floating in a small ark in the river and had compassion on him and raised him as her own. Moses was a worshiper of our God, so God found favor with him. He was able to deliver his people, the Israelites, out of bondage and out of Egypt to the promised land. Yeah. Praise God for Moses. Daniel decided to be faithful to the Lord and not bowing to other gods. The Lord, in return, rescued him from the lion's den without so much as a scratch. You guys all know the stories or events about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They were thrown in the fiery furnace, and they were saved because they were worshipers of our God. They wouldn't bow down to other gods. There have been many times throughout the Old Testament times that God has forgiven those who have forsaken him or turned away from him. They find that life is much better with him in their lives. He was true and just to forgive them for straying. He provided them with many life-saving miracles, and he continued to show compassion on those who chose to believe in him and to worship him and follow his commandments. They find that life is much easier if they follow the first and most important commandment. Do we know what it is? Yes. Praise God. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. The number one commandment. If it wasn't important, it wouldn't be number one. Okay, well, that's the first part of my sermon. That's basically the Old Testament part of it. I'm going to skip into the New Testament part. I called it Choose Jesus. First part was a gift of choice. Second part is choose Jesus.
Amen. That's right.
We have the gift of choice to choose Jesus. We better do it. Because the world was becoming more and more corrupt, and because of man's sinful nature, instead of destroying all of mankind again, God made a choice to devise a way for man to have a way to make it to heaven. He made the ultimate atoning sacrifice for us. God sacrificed his one and only son, Jesus, so we can make the choice.
That's right.
I emphasize the choice.
That's right.
The most important choice you'll ever make in your life.
Amen.
Praise God. The decision is to choose Jesus rather than living a life of sin and suffering and eternity burning in hell. During Jesus' ministry, many people chose Jesus. We'll start with his first four disciples, Peter, Andrew, James, and John. They were all fishermen. You guys all here know. Oh, goodbye. They were all fishermen, and Jesus was walking along the beach or along the waterline there, and he's telling them to drop your nets and follow me.
Right.
I don't know what it was about him, but you know, they didn't know him from a bag of beans, but they followed him. He says, "I'll make you fishers of men." That's what he said.
Amen.
They chose Jesus, and they did so without hesitation. There's many others in here that chose Jesus, and they reaped great benefits from it. In Matthew 8, the leper chose Jesus and was healed.
Amen.
A centurion chose Jesus, and because of his faith, his servant was healed back at home.
Amen.
That was powerful. In Matthew 9, 1 and 2, a man with palsy is healed. Jesus enters into a ship and passes over to a city. Keyword, they here. Wait a minute. A man with palsy is healed. Jesus enters into a ship and passes over to a city. And they, keyword they, brought unto him a sick man, sick with palsy, lying on a bed. And Jesus, seeing their faith, said unto the sick of the palsy, "Son of good cheer, be of good cheer, thy sins be forgiven."
Amen.
He was unable to do it himself, but because of their faith, he could still be healed.
Amen.
This man was healed because of his family and friends. They chose Jesus.
Yeah.
Their belief and faith in Jesus healed the man sick with palsy. The paralyzed man couldn't do it on his own because the devil had a hold on him in such a way that he couldn't choose Jesus on his own. But we have the power to defeat the devil for others if we make that decision. Matthew 14, 14 to 21. The multitudes chose to follow Jesus, and he showed compassion on them and healed the sick and fed 5,000 men besides women and children. Men back then could have many wives and many children. So 5,000 plus. He fed them with 5 loaves and 2 fish. Jesus multiplied the 5 loaves and 2 fish to feed 5,000 men plus women and children. And he was all done feeding them. Everybody was full. And he still had 12 baskets left. You know, overflowing baskets of loaves and fish. All because of the multitude of people chose Jesus.
Amen.
They made the choice.
Right.
Mark 5, 25 to 32. Randy preached a little bit on this last week about the woman with the issue of blood. And Pastor mentioned it too in his service. She's been bleeding for 12 years. She spent all of her money on doctors and did all she could, and they just gave her a death sentence, more or less. They couldn't do anything for her. She was given a death sentence from the devil to live out the rest of her life as an unclean person, to die alone, and to not be allowed in public. She chose to believe in Jesus.
Amen. Right.
She chose Jesus.
Right.
She had so much faith in Jesus that she somehow knew all she had to do was touch his garment and she would be healed. That was the title of your sermon last week, I think, was Touch Jesus.
Yes.
And she would be healed. She worked her way through the mob and managed to touch his outer garment. And Jesus knew he was touched by an unclean person. Even though he was being mobbed and rubbed and touched by many, many people, he could tell through his clothes that a person of great faith had taken some of his virtue out of him and defeated the devil. She was healed for her bleeding and uncleanness because she chose Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Jesus was crucified with two criminals, one on each side of him. Luke 23:39-43. One of the criminals, with the rest of the rulers and non-believers, mocked Jesus. Now they were telling him that if you are the Son of God, you save so many people, why can't you save yourself? Get off the cross. You know, you're so great. Get on from there. Save us too while you're at it. The man on the other side of Jesus was more or less telling the guy on the other cross, the sinner, that, like, shut up, you know. It's like, we deserve to be here. He doesn't. He never did anything wrong. All he did was help people, and we deserve to be here, and he doesn't. And that guy, that sinner, asked Jesus, you know, to save him, you know, to remember him. And Jesus told him that you will be with me in paradise tonight.
Amen.
Because he chose Jesus. This is proof that it doesn't matter who you are or what you have done in the past. You will be forgiven for any and all of your sins if you choose Jesus. You could probably start working your way forward if you want to sing your song. I'd appreciate it. Sum things up, we have the gift of choice. We need to choose Jesus as our Lord and Savior if we haven't yet. In our prayers, we need to thank God for Jesus. We need to thank Jesus for the unfathomable pain and suffering he endured for us, for being the ultimate atoning sacrifice, for being our doorway to heaven. I don't know about you, but as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Paul is on now.
this life, something that would fill my empty soul. Some believe a lie, choose darkness over light, but I will stand and let the whole world know I choose Jesus.
Heavenly Father, thank you for this time. Thank you for Jesus dying on the cross for our sins. We thank you for the choice of choosing Jesus. We love and praise and worship you, Father. We pray that you lay a healing hand on those that need it. We pray for blessings for all that are here and listening. We love you, Father, with all of our hearts. We pray that your word doesn't go out and return void. Praise you, Father God, with all our hearts. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Are you going to pray for anyone if they need prayer tonight? All right, praise God. If anyone needs prayer tonight, praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God.